about the Connoisseur beer event. According to the guys from the beer event, apparently there were a 60% increase of budget sold. So that means that the community has sponsored us enough. But of course, you all came to the beer for sponsoring us. That's okay. So we have a lot of stuff going on this weekend. As you can see, I'm not going to go over all the different numbers. Especially the stands are a bit more scattered now than last year's. And the total amount of hours that we have now is 310 hours. We did a short calculation, and it means that if you would benchmark all the video that we're taking, we'll probably see that you would need just under 2 weeks if you watch it 24/7. So don't try to do that, but just to, so you know. Yes, so Wi-Fi network, still the same as last year. We still have default ESSI FOSAM, which is IPv6 only. In case you still need legacy IP, then you can still use the FOSAM fallback network, which provides still legacy IP connectivity. Furthermore, we have also new stuff on the video. This is a picture taken from last year. Somewhere at night, the video team, the setup, you can see a lot of boxes, a lot of wiring. The two laptops were even required to actually work with the whole thing. But we tried to increase that this year. We tried to redo that, and these are the video boxes this year. There's two boxes going in each room. It's basically a summary of all the devices you saw there and all the cabling, bundled in one box with an LCD. So now we hope that the video team can work easier, and also the volunteers, of course. And especially also that they don't have to manage all those devices. They just need to point the camera towards the speaker, and I hope they can all do that, because last year there was even a recording a couple of hours of the wall. But I hope they can do that better. So then, this venue is ULP. As you probably know, that's already 3 years that they are actually lending us actually this university for a weekend. We're very happy that we can actually use this event, this venue, because there were people also saying on the social media that why can't we do it somewhere else? Well, they have the largest auditoriums, the most space here, I think, in Belgium. Some people suggested that we move it to Italy or something, but we'd rather not do that. Then, also about the venue, we'd like to ask you, please, can you clean up after yourself? Please, can you put the glass and then make the boxes? We have had some complaints last year. We'd like everybody to respect the environment, to really help us out, also for the cleanup event. And all but at least, definitely no tape or stickers on the wall, because the paint might come off and you have to pay fines for that. Then, there is also in each room normally an open-closed sign, at least the smaller rooms, because it's impossible to fit a lot of people in tiny spaces. So we would like you to please respect the full signs. It's for everybody's safety also. If the rooms are crowded, if there's something going on, then that people still can get out. And there is also a QR code on each of the doors. So in case you can't enter the room anymore, you should be able to follow the live feed from the video. Then this is an overview map of the campus. I hope you all realize you're in the J building right now, or at least you could find it. The main effort is actually at the K building, which is the other side of the parking box, so if you leave from the back. There's also the first aid there. Next to us is the H building, over there, which holds a bit of stands and also a secondary interest, and also the rally stand. Then across of that is also the AW building, which is mostly for embedded, but we had to pull some stands from there and the H building also. And then on top of that, we have a U-shaped building, that's the building. One of the changes for this year is also that before we had the shuttle buses on Sunday leaving from Avenue Bell, from the side of Avenue Bell, but since that's not possible because there's still roadworks going on, actually the shuttle buses on Sunday are also leaving at the bowling here in front of the J building, next to the Fries and Burger stand, which is right next to the street. So, should be signage pointing to that. But anyway, make sure if you want to take the shuttle buses on Sunday evening that you actually catch it there and not on the top of the map. Furthermore, there's also a note about the U building. Key signing is taking place in the UD building. It's actually the first block of the new building closest to the food court. That's taking place this Saturday, so there should also be signage, but if you're wondering, it's in the hallway of the new building because there's not a room large enough to actually hold the key sign. Then there's some special stuff still going on, last minute, as you all might know. Ian Murdoch died just the end of this year. So there is a special meeting here at 18 o'clock for him and in memoriam, where they will show a video and some kind words from the DBN community. And also some last minute changes. I think we will do that for booklet actually. If you're in booklet, you will find the t-shirts. If you we sell t-shirts like every year, so it's 25 euros for a t-shirt. If you give us 50 euros, you get a t-shirt and a voucher for a rally pocketbook. If you give us 100 euros, or more of course, we like the community to contribute next to the sponsorship we get from the corporate. So 100 euros, you get a t-shirt and a voucher for a full book in the rally that you can pick up at your rally stand. Also, the booklets, the printed versions, and the PDFs which are online, there are still some errors in there, like everybody else. We're also having problems with Murphy all the time. And also there were some speakers last minute who cancelled. So lightning talks, there are some changes. Apparently there was also one room which is actually misnumbered in the booklet. So please check the online schedules and the online applications, because those contain the latest information and the latest updates for everything. We try to also put that on the social media. And then of course, we'd like to thank our sponsors, especially our cornerstone sponsor Red Hat, which has been for a couple of years already our main sponsor. You might know it, you might like it. The Shadow Man figure is all known, I think, and it's one of the largest open source software vendors and also works a lot with the community. Then next to that we have Bloomberg, which is a financial market data provider. Cisco, already for a couple of years, there are Cisco people trying to maintain our network here, up and running. Then we have CodeTech, Colt, which is our main provider for the internet now. Goras, Freemost, GitHub, you might probably know. Google, largest search provider, and one of the largest financial sponsors also in this event. HP, the small little bullet that is Minio. I don't know why we don't have an X next to them, but anyway. MySQL, we probably know too. Corelli, of course, for the books. And Vivago, maybe you ordered your hotel through this channel. So, thank you, and please enjoy your weekend.